Empathy, it's not just for humans anymore. Hey guys, Tara here for D News, and if you've been on the internet the past few days, then you might have seen this story about Koko the gorilla mourning the death of Robin Williams. Koko is part of California's Gorilla Foundation, and she's well known for her fluency in English. She's capable of signing and communicating over 1,000 words in English. Back in 2004, Williams visited Koko to film a PSA for the foundation, and the two developed a special bond. So earlier this week, when Koko heard of his passing, photos surfaced on the internet showing her emotional reaction to hearing the news. According to her caretaker, she became incredibly somber, quivering her lip, and signing the words "woman" and "cry." Now, aside from being horribly sad, part of the reason this story is gaining so much attention is that a lot of us out there assume that humans are the only animals capable of experiencing empathy. Primate researchers will tell you differently, but it's still a widely debated topic. And a new study published this week in PeerJ aims to examine the relationship between human empathy and empathy of apes. Specifically, they looked at bonobos, which are our closest evolutionary cousins, and they examined them under the context of emotional contagion. That's when you transfer your emotions to another person using facial expressions, and it's widely considered to be the most basic form of empathy. One of the most trivial forms of that can be seen with yawn contagion, or contagious yawning. Interestingly, humans and bonobos are the only two species where yawn contagion seems to follow an empathic trend, meaning it's more likely to happen between individuals who share a strong emotional bond, which is another reason why they chose bonobos for this study. Over the course of 5 years, a team of researchers observed both humans and bonobos doing everyday activities, and they took note of how many times each individual responded to another's yawns and how quickly it took them to respond. It turns out that in cases where the yawner and the responder were not friends, bonobos responded just as quickly to another's yawns as humans did, meaning emotional contagion may be just as prominent in bonobos as it is in humans. However, in cases where the yawner and the responder were close or had a strong bond, humans still reacted more quickly to someone else's yawns than bonobos. Researchers believe this might be due to the complex emotional foundations that human relationships are built on, but it still highlights an important conclusion of the study, which is that when it comes to empathy, a close relationship between individuals is more important than their species. The Robin Williams story is a good example of that, but there's an even better one involving the same gorilla, Koko, adopting a kitten, caring for it for many months, and then expressing deep sadness when she learns the kitten died. That story has since been adapted into a children's book, and it is a poignant example of the deep emotional bonds that can exist between two individuals, even those of wildly different species. I'm sure some of you out there have pets or similar stories of bonds you've developed with other animals, and if so, feel free to share them in the comments below. As always, thank you guys for watching.